Thank you. That concludes the debate on a resilience fund for CalMac disruption. It's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is an urgent question, and I call Sandesh Gulhani.
To ask the Scottish Government what its response is to the announcement that Scottish junior doctors have voted overwhelmingly to reject the pay offer made by the Scottish Government and plan to take strike action.
Cabinet Secretary Michael Matheson.
Officer, we're disappointed that junior doctors have rejected our cumulative pay uplift of 14.5% over 2 years and decided on industrial action, which is in no one's interest. We negotiated in good faith, addressed concerns from junior doctors. It was the biggest investment junior doctors paid for the last 20 years and a step forward in modernising pay bargaining, restoring confidence amongst junior doctors and ensuring that their contribution to our healthcare system is appropriately recognised. I've also been very clear with the BMA that the request for a 35% increase is unaffordable, with the funding for any increase in pay likely to come from the health budget. However, I continue to engage with the BMA Scotland and will meet tomorrow to discuss how we can move forward.
Sandesh Gulhani.
Last week, I met with the Royal College of Emergency Medicine, who told me that last winter was the worst winter they have endured. Whilst patients waited for hours to be seen in A&E, staff were pushed to the brink, with many working long hours in understaffed wards, and this is on top of punishing previous years. Scottish Conservatives' Freedom of Information request showed almost 75,000 NHS staff have been absent in the last 5 years due to anxiety, stress, depression and other mental health-related illnesses. Morale is at rock bottom in the Scottish Health Service. Given the precarious nature of our services, can the Cabinet Secretary guarantee that the current offer and any further offers and future offers that he will make will not be taking funding away from crucial frontline services?
Cabinet Secretary.
Presiding Officer, I must confess I've heard of leading with your chin in a debate, but this is some brass neck.
Absolutely.
At the Conservative Party have got.
On the very day
when in England junior doctors are on the third round of industrial action because of failure of the Conservative government in England to even engage with them meaningfully is quite stark. It is quite stark, Prime Officer. I'm sure Mr. Gulhani recognises how important we recognise this issue as, which is why we have been in detailed negotiations with junior doctors over a considerable period of time, and why the BMA viewed the offer that was made to them as being credible enough to put to their members. What I can assure the member that I will not do, I will not disrespect junior doctors in the way in which his colleagues in England have.
Yeah.
I will engage with them in a serious and in a meaningful way, and with a sense of humility to try and address the concerns and the issues that they have, rather than arrogantly dismissing their issues of concern, as his colleagues in Westminster are doing. But you can be assured that I'll continue to engage with them in a way that seeks to try and address their concerns and to find a resolution to this matter, because I believe it's in everyone's interest, right across our NHS and right across our wider society, to make sure that junior doctors are treated with respect and get the type of support and assistance that they require.
Sandesh Gulhani.
What an arrogant answer. And quite frankly, the Cabinet Secretary didn't even bother to answer the question which was put to him. As a NHS GP who is currently working, I can categorically tell you how difficult things are right now.
Members, let's hear one another.
Health is devolved in Scotland. Simply put, this is your mess to fix. Of course our junior doctors deserve a fair pay offer, but the SNP government have consistently neglected other areas of terms and conditions. Poor workforce planning, lack of access to nutritious meals and a culture that doesn't value frontline staff has all contributed to these strikes. Can the Cabinet Secretary guarantee this issue will be addressed when he next sits with the junior doctors, which is, he said, tomorrow? And could he actually answer my question from the last time?
Cabinet Secretary.
I think Mr. Gulhani's got himself into a bit of a guddle on this particular issue. Let me be quite clear. So it's not just me. It's not just the Cabinet Secretary for Health is saying what we're doing with the BMA. Let me just quote from the BMA today in the letter which they issued, Presiding Officer, because it's exceptionally relevant
the Cabinet Secretary.
To the point that has been raised by the member. A letter which is to Rishi Sunak on this particular issue, and I quote,
Members, can we please have silence in the chamber when a member is on their feet, putting or responding to a question? Cabinet Secretary.
So, as it says in the letter, and I quote, as you will be aware, there, with no additional funding, both the Welsh and the Scottish Government have recognised the real terms cut to doctors' pay. Yet your government still refuses to acknowledge pay erosion. Yeah. So this is a letter from the BMA recognising that we as a government understand and are concerned about the issues that junior doctors have, pointing out the heartless, empty rhetoric that's come from the UK government and his colleagues at Westminster. And I'm sure, I don't know if the member's a member of the BMA, but it's very clear from the BMA, they think that the Conservative Party, his party leader, is not interested in the interests of junior doctors. But what I can assure the member, and I'm sure him and his colleagues will want to hear this, is I'll do everything I can to try to address their concerns. I will negotiate with them in a meaningful and in a genuine way. What I won't do to junior doctors is to dismiss them as though you're not interested in their concerns in the way in which his colleagues and his party leader at Westminster has done. And he can be assured that we will do the right thing by junior doctors, unlike his colleagues in Westminster.
Claire Hawley.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. As the Cabinet Secretary has already referenced, the BMA today wrote to Rishi Sunak asking to meet him urgently to find a resolution to the ongoing dispute in England. Can the Cabinet Secretary outline what engagements the Scottish Government has had with the BMA to address these concerns while the UK Government continue to fail to listen to junior doctors?
Cabinet Secretary.
Officer, I'm going to be meeting again with the BMA tomorrow to discuss these matters, and I've had extensive engagement with the BMA. We've very, very positive relationships in terms of engaging around this particular issue, and I want to very much keep it in that footing. I did hear from a secretary position some people saying, questioning this issue about the letter from the BMA, why is it relevant? The reason it's relevant is because it references the Scottish Government and the Welsh Government's efforts to try and resolve the issue, unlike their counterparts in Westminster. And maybe there's some backbone in the Tory benches to stand up for junior doctors in Scotland, rather than as ever,
members,
pandering to their Westminster masters when it comes to dealing with these issues.
Jackie Bailey.
Can I welcome the Cabinet Secretary's comments so far, but gently point out to him that pay erosion began in 2008, the same period that the SNP have been in government for. Half of junior doctors are actively considering leaving to work elsewhere. So can the Cabinet Secretary advise what additional action he can take to avoid a strike and to avoid losing junior doctors from the NHS completely? And can he also advise of any contingency arrangements should his discussions fail?
Cabinet Secretary.
So let me deal with the last point first. And there are contingency arrangements being put in place just now, and we are engaging with health boards around that. We have been doing that for a number of weeks now to prepare for any potential industrial action, as the member would recognise. I would also gently remind Jackie Bailey the issue about pay erosion starting in 2008. Junior doctors' pay settlements are agreed through the DDRB process, which applies across the whole of the UK. So Labour governments in Wales, Labour governments at a UK level have applied that as well during that period of time, and we have applied it and we've always been committed to that. One of the things that we agreed with the Junior Doctors Committee on was their desire to move to a new pay negotiation process, and we committed to doing that, to establish that process. We were prepared to take that work forward in order to make sure that it was in place by September of this year, and it's something which I stand by and will continue to offer to them as we move forward. But junior doctors too now have been committed to the DDRB process, as her colleagues in Wales are, as is the case in England as well. So it's been a well-established approach to try and apportion it as though it's more of a blame on the SNP than anyone else is simply wrong and would be misleading to do so.
Exactly.
We have always honoured the recommendations within that process. We are now in a situation where junior doctors wish to take a different approach, and actually the only government in the UK so far that has been committed to doing that is the Scottish Government. So I stand by that commitment I've given to the BMA, and we'll continue to work with them over the coming weeks to look at how we can make further progress on this issue.
Alex Cole-Hamilton.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And can I say, I find it very poor that SNP backbenchers were jeering and moaning when Dr Gilhani declared his interest as a practising GP. I think it's a level of contempt from the backbenchers of the SNP that primary healthcare workers are all too familiar with. Presiding Officer, the Cabinet Secretary's predecessor, put great store in the fact that Scotland did not have healthcare strikes, yet come July that could be proved wrong and those words could come back to haunt him. It will mean that every ward is a little less safe. Every wait in a hospital or for treatment is perhaps a little longer. So what does the Cabinet Secretary have to say to those patients waiting in pain?
Cabinet Secretary.
Senator Officer, I presume that the member is keen for us to try and avoid industrial action. What we have always done in relation to the disputes we've had with health unions is to engage with them in a constructive way in order to try and seek a resolution to these matters. And that approach today has allowed Scotland to be the only part of the UK where we've been able to avoid industrial action within our NHS. I would have thought at the very least the member would have welcomed that approach, that partnership approach in working with trade unions to try and address the issues of concern which their members have. We have taken that approach into our engagement with the Junior Doctors Committee of the BMA. I'm continuing to be committed to that approach with them. We'll re-engage tomorrow and we'll look to see what further progress we can make going forward. I don't believe industrial action is in anyone's interest. Ultimately, it will be a decision for junior doctors to make on whether they choose to take industrial action. But I will do everything I can to try and avoid that. And I will engage with them in a meaningful way through the negotiation process to try and achieve that. And if we are able to achieve it, then we'll be able to make sure that we can move on in addressing the issues of concern that junior doctors have.
Thank you. That concludes the urgent question. Point of order, Sandesh Gulhani. Thank you, Mr. Gulhani. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 9501 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and moved.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak on the motion, and the question is that motion 9501 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed, and the next item of business is consideration of business motion 9502 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on timetabling of a bill at stage one. Any member who wishes to speak against the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
And once again, Presiding Officer, moved.
Thank you. No member has asked to speak against the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 9502 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. And the next item of business is consideration of 5 Parliamentary Bureau motions. And I ask George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, to move motions 9503 and 9504 on approval of SSIs, 9505 and 9524 on designation of a lead committee, and 9538 on committee membership.
All moved, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. The question on these motions will be put at decision time. There are 7 questions to be put as a result of today's business. And can I remind members that if the amendment in the name of Michael Matheson is agreed to, the amendment in the name of Sandesh Gilhani will fall. And the first question is that amendment 9462.2 in the name of Michael Matheson, which seeks to amend motion 9462 in the name of Jackie Bailey on taking action on NHS waiting times, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.